Greetings from Elysium Academy. Today we are going to discuss about the connection multiplexing. The multiple connections may be established from one component to another component or other component. Some type of multiplexing function is needed to differentiate between data traversing the various connections. This ensures that the transport layer can send data from particular application to correct destination and application. And when receiving data from a destination, get it to the right local application. To accomplish this, the transport layer technically assigns a unique set of numbers for each connection. These numbers are commonly packed and it is being called as port or socket numbers. Yeah, source port number and the destination port number are assigned for each connection. The destination port number assigned by the source device are sometimes referred as well-known or reserved port numbers. The source device uses an appropriate port number in the destination port field to indicate to the destination which application it is trying to access. For example, the TCP/IP protocol stack gives each application a unique port number. Some well-known port numbers used by TCP/IP application are FTP 20 and 21, Telnet 23, SMTP for email 25, DNS 53, TFTP 69, WWW 80, and POP 110. The TCP/IP port numbers from 0 to 1023 are well-known ports. However, some applications have port numbers higher than these numbers. Actually, the TCP/IP uses 16-bit field for the port number, allowing you to refer up to 16,536 different numbers. Port number above 1023 are used by the source to assign the connection as the source port number. Each connection on the source has a unique source port number. So these are some of the functionalities of the connection multiplexing. To know more about this, you can contact Elysium Academy. Thank you.